The U.S. Air Force stated on October 20th that it plans to reveal the B-21 Raider stealth bomber aircraft on December 2nd during an unveiling ceremony hosted and sponsored by the Northrop Grumman Corporation. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes how B-21 Raider is shaping up. Let's get started. This video is sponsored by the free-to-play online military-themed strategy game, Conflict of Nations, which is played by millions of players worldwide. We talk a lot about military power and tactical plans of different nations on this channel, but what about trying them out for yourself? Conflict of Nations is set in the late 20th and early 21st century, fielding present-day and highly modern battlefield technology. At the core of the game is an exciting real-time combat system, placing players in control of an existing nation of this world and its army, pitting them against other gamers in a struggle for world domination. Units are moved across the map in real time, often taking hours to fulfill their assigned mission goals, allowing for a very deep level of strategic planning and integrated tactical execution. Forming lasting alliances or short-lived coalitions is an essential part of the modern military environment. Hence, Conflict of Nations allows players to form cooperative plans and teams in an all-out effort to conquer set objectives through the combined force of arms. Conflict of Nations can be played in PC or mobile. So why wait? Register yourself using the link in the description below and get 13,000 gold reward along with 1 month Security Council membership. The B-21 is a long-range, highly survivable, penetrating strike stealth bomber that will incrementally replace the B-1 and B-2 bombers and is expected to become the backbone of the U.S. Air Force bomber fleet. The Department of the Air Force is investing in the aircraft's long-range strike capability as part of its 7 operational imperatives. Number 1. Defining resilient and effective space order of battle and architecture. Number 2. Achieving operationally optimized Advanced Battle Management Systems (ABMS) and Air Force Joint All-Domain Command and Control AFJADC2. 3. Defining the Next Generation Air Dominance NGAD System of Systems. 4. Achieving moving target engagement at scale in a challenging operational environment. 5. Defining optimized resilient basing, sustainment, and communications in a contested environment. 6. Defining the B-21 long-range strike family of systems. 7. Readiness of the Department of the Air Force to transition to a wartime posture against a peer competitor. Secretary of the Air Force Frank Kendall, when talking about these, explained, "The 6th imperative has a heavy focus on hardware. As in other imperatives, this one has echoes to others in the list. This initiative, similar to NGAD, identifies all the components of the B-21 family of systems, including the potential use of more affordable, uncrewed, autonomous combat aircraft," he said. He added, "The technologies are there now to introduce uncrewed platforms in this system of systems context, but the most cost-effective approach, and the operational concepts for this, complement to crewed global strike capabilities, have to be analyzed and defined." Kendall also provided more insights, stating, "We're looking for systems that cost nominally on the order of at least half as much as the manned systems that we're talking about for both NGAD and for B-21 while adding capability. They could deliver a range of sensors, other mission payloads and weapons, or other mission equipment, and they can also be attritable or even sacrificed if doing so conferred a major operational advantage, something we would never do with a crewed platform." B-21 Raider is stealthier, with a more optimized airframe, new radar-absorbing material, and improved exhaust control to reduce the heat signature. It's slightly smaller than B-2 but more nimble, has improved performance, can accommodate a more diversified and dynamic payload, and hosts advanced communications and sensor suite. It's designed with an open systems architecture, enabling rapid insertion of mature technologies and allowing the aircraft to remain effective as threats evolve over time. Air Force Chief of Staff General C.Q. Brown Jr. said, "The unveiling of the B-21 Raider will be a historic moment for our Air Force and the nation. We last introduced a new bomber over 30 years ago. As we look to the threats posed by our pacing challenge, we must continue to rapidly modernize. The B-21 Raider will provide formidable combat capability across a range of operations in highly contested environments of the future." Andrew Hunter, Assistant Secretary of the Air Force for Acquisition, Technology, and Logistics, stated, "The B-21 program is a powerful example of America's long experience with fielding advanced military technology through an innovative, adaptable, and efficient defense industrial base. The Air Force made the decision early in the life of the program to make the flight test aircraft production representative, which is paying dividends as we look towards first flight." The B-21 system is manufactured under the U.S. Air Force contract with Northrop Grumman. While not officially revealed, Northrop Grumman is building the B-21 in its factory at Air Force Plant 42 in Palmdale, California. The company announced the rollout date on Twitter. Interestingly, the first week in December rollout coincides with the Reagan National Defense Forum at the Reagan Library. The B-21, the first new Air Force bomber since the B-2 Spirit rolled out in Palmdale in 1988, is expected to make its first flight in mid-2023. Unlike most such events, including the B-21's predecessor, B-2 Spirit, the December 2nd ceremony will reportedly be a higher security event. It will be open to invitees only and will have tight restrictions on photography. After unveiling, the B-21 program will continue its extensive testing campaign with a combined team of professionals from the Air Force Test Center, Air Force Operational Test and Evaluation Center, and Northrop Grumman. Their work will verify performance and identify areas for improvement for the weapon system. According to the U.S. Air Force, the first B-21 to roll out will be one of six already in production. Air Force Global Strike Command wants a fleet of 150 B-21s, but no fewer than 100 of the new stealth bombers. Anti-Access Area Denial (A2AD) systems refuse U.S. forces the ability to come within hundreds or even thousands of miles of an enemy's territory. These capabilities include advanced integrated air defense systems with long-range engagement capabilities able to target and shoot down aircraft from hundreds of miles away, an example being the Russian S-400. Today, these high-end capabilities are being developed and deployed by near-peer rivals like China and Russia, but they will soon be available to others as well. In this situation, B-21 Raider will be a key asset since it has features that make it suitable for penetrating highly defended airspace. As Russia and China still struggle with stealth technology, with no operational stealth bomber and no possibility of having anything soon, B-21 will catapult the U.S. to a league of its own.
Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.